So this is what we are doing presently. We are studying the preparation of alcohols. And in the previous presentations, I have given you already, I think, two methods of preparations, one from the haloalkanes, another from alkenes. That of alkenes was a little bit elaborate, but we have done it already. We'll move to the third method, which is we are able to prepare alcohols from carbonyl compounds also. The third method of preparation of alcohols is that they can be prepared from carbonyl compounds. So the first thing we need to remember or learn here is a carbonyl compound kya hota hai? The name carbonyl is given to the group CO. So kisi bhi functional group mein ya CO directly present ho ya CO is the part of the group, that compound is a carbonyl compound. And isme kaun kaun se functional groups aate hain? We have aldehydes in this, because aldehyde actually structure iska hai C double bond OH. It has a CO group, it has a carbonyl group. Ketones fall under this category, they have a CO group. Carboxylic acids are carbonyl compounds, they contain CO group, and all the derivatives of carboxylic acids, in this case we'll take esters only, but all the derivatives of carboxylic acids in which H is replaced by something else are also carbonyl compounds because they also contain CO group. So in this step, in this method of preparation, we'll be carrying out the reaction of aldehydes, ketones, carboxylic acids and esters, and see how they can give us alcohols, right? The reaction involved, the process involved by which we can do this, by which we can prepare an alcohol from a carbonyl compound, is reduction. Right now, reduction ki bahut sari definitions hai. You have studied reduction last year, you have studied reduction this year in electrochemistry also. It is addition of hydrogen, or it is removal of oxygen, right? Or it is addition of any other electropositive element, or it is removal of any other electronegative element. There are so many definitions, but in this preparation we'll be simply doing this. We'll be adding hydrogen so that we can prepare an alcohol from a carbonyl compound, right? And we'll do this reaction in two parts. The first part is we'll see how by reduction of aldehydes having the functional group CHO and ketones we can have alcohols. In the first part, sirf hum reduction of aldehydes and ketones se prepare karenge alcohols. Now this reaction can be carried out in following ways. Number one, catalytic hydrogenation. All of this description is important to do before we start the reactions. We have to learn how we can prepare alcohols from carbonyl compounds. Catalytic hydrogenation of aldehydes and ketones. Hydrogenation means addition of hydrogen. And when you're doing that, when you're doing addition of hydrogen in the presence of a catalyst like nickel or platinum or palladium, the process is called as catalytic hydrogenation, right? Number two, it can be carried out by action of sodium on alcohol, on ethanol. We can use sodium on ethanol as a reducing agent. And number three, I'll just adjust that here. Number three, we can use reducing agents, metal hydrides like lithium, aluminium hydride, it is a reducing agent, or we can also use sodium borohydride, right? So let's do a quick recap. What we are doing is we are trying to prepare an alcohol from a carbonyl compound. In the first part, we'll do that by reduction of aldehydes and ketones. And how can we carry out that reduction? Either by catalytic hydrogenation, simply adding hydrogen in the presence of any of these catalysts, or by action of sodium on ethanol, sodium used on ethanol, or by using a complex metal hydride like lithium aluminium hydride or sodium borohydride. Let's take a look at the reactions. What is this? From carbonyl compounds, in which our first part is by reduction of aldehydes and ketones. Now the general formula of an aldehyde is RCHO. R is the carbon hydrogen network and the functional group here is CHO, therefore the compound is an aldehyde. You simply have to do this because we have already written about the ways of reduction. I'll just put in everything here. We can do hydrogenation in the presence of a catalyst like nickel, or we can use sodium on alcohol, C2H5OH on ethanol, or we can use a reducing agent like lithium aluminium hydride, or we can use sodium borohydride. Any of these, not all of these together, just one of these will be enough. Using these, any of these as a reducing agent, what we get is RCH2OH, an alcohol. Right? Similarly, if we use a ketone, R-R-C double bond O. Now you do know that this R and R dash can be similar. They're called as simple ketones and they can be dissimilar. Then it is simply a mixed ketone. And using any of the above given reducing agents, let's just write down one here, hydrogenation in the presence of a catalyst. What we get is R-R dash. In place of C double bond O, we have CHOH. We have added hydrogen. C double bond O is converted into CHOH. This is reduction, and the reduction gives us an alcohol. What is very, very important to remember about this reaction is, which you must have observed, that jab aap aldehyde ki reduction karenge, for the preparation of alcohols from carbonyl compounds, jab aap aldehyde ki reduction karenge, your product is not simply alcohol, it is a 1 degree alcohol. You get a primary alcohol. If the required alcohol is a primary alcohol, you will do that by reducing an aldehyde. And by the reduction of a ketone, what is your product? It is not just an alcohol, it is a 2 degree alcohol. So agar answer mein aapki requirement hai ki you need to produce a 2 degree, a secondary alcohol, you will start with a ketone. Right? Remember these two important points. From aldehyde, you'll get a primary alcohol. From a ketone, you will get a secondary alcohol. Let's quickly do a specific reaction of both of these. Specifically, let's start with acetaldehyde, CH3CHO. The name in IUPAC system is ethanol. Eth because two carbon atoms, al, A-N-E-A-N because single bond, carbon-carbon single bond, al because this is the functional group. It's a terminal functional group, its carbon number is always carbon number 1, thus it, right? You add hydrogen, we are carrying out hydrogenation in the presence of nickel or platinum. You can use any of the methods which I have given you, and what you get is CH3CH2OH. The compound is ethanol. Right. Similarly, if we start with the simplest ketone, which is acetone, in which R and R dash are similar, and we carry out the reduction addition of hydrogen in the presence of a catalyst, thus it will be a catalytic hydrogenation. CH3 apni jagah pe, CH3 apni jagah pe. In place of CO, it gets reduced. The whole group CO gets reduced. We have CHOH, right? Now what is this compound? 1, 2, 3. Propen-2-ol. This is ethanol. You can write down ethan-1-ol also. This is propen-2-ol. So what is to be noted? Two things are to be noted. From an aldehyde, what you got is a 1 degree alcohol. a primary alcohol, and from a ketone, which is acetone in this case, you got a 2 degree. You did prepare an alcohol, but which alcohol? Secondary alcohol. Second thing you remember is that the number of carbon atoms remains the same. आप जितने कार्बन एटम से स्टार्ट करते हैं रिएक्शन, जितने कार्बन एटम्स आपके रिएक्टेंट में हैं, इट इज़ द सेम इन द प्रोडक्ट. इथ इथ राइट, यू स्टार्ट विथ 3 carbon atoms हियर, यू हैव 3 carbon atoms इन द प्रोडक्ट. राइट, दिस इज प्रिपरेशन ऑफ एल्कोहल्स फ्रॉम एल्डिहाइड्स एंड कीटोन्स. हाउ वी डू इट? बाय रिडक्शन ऑफ एल्डिहाइड्स एंड कीटोन्स. विल कंटिन्यू इन द नेक्स्ट वन.